bastante caliente, muy picante. Oh, I think I saw your coochie coochie, by the way. Oh, yeah.
No. Just stay over here. Stay over here. You really have to be off by 10. 40 for Charo and Keo.
¿Por qué?
Of course, they also want votes from you to escape this season's first elimination.
I got my eyes on you.
Okay. Last week.
Your English
sucks. I have to do this. I have to host.
Your English sucks.
On the season finale of The Bachelor, our next star took himself off the market when he proposed to the love of his recent life. And just a few weeks before that, his dance parts here from them.
Right here.
Because that's the employer. Bruno, what do you think?
Oh, ole! Charo, la grande passionaria! You were unleashed on the ground floor. You were like a tornado, red taffeta. Look at you, you're mo coochie coochie. No mo coochie coochie, Charo.
Oh, my God.
You are all your own special creation.
You have an accent.
Do I have an accent?
Yes.
I never noticed.
I know. We have to do the show. Other people have to dance. Carrie Ann, with you, that's my gift to you.
Everybody say, ole!
Back there. Later tonight, your votes from last Monday's premiere will be combined with last week's judges' scores. The couple with the lowest combined total will be eliminated at the end of the show. Erin, can you get my microphone back?
I think I need security back here. Oh, they took the mic from her. All right, here comes Charo and Keo. Well,
there we go.
I'm just going to ask you, and I'm going to hold my microphone very tight. What did you think of the Cuatro Amigos comments?
They were very good tonight, except that I didn't know what the hell Bruno was talking about. He had a terrible accent.
You didn't know what
Don't worry, my darling, nor
what?
Do I.
Bruno, you got to go to school. Your English sucks.
Oh! No. I will learn from you, sweetheart.
All right, let's find out how these judges scored you. All right.
Carrie Ann Inaba.
Okay, 6.
Len Goodman.
6.
Julianne Hough.
7.
Bruno Tognoli.
6.
No, say your old, dear. Oh, no. 26 out of 40. We got you for 26 out of 40.
Right,
And guess what? 25 out of 40. And if you can make it past tonight's elimination, tell everybody at home.
This is bad.
No, it's not bad. You just need everyone to vote for you. So tell them.
Vote.
I'm going to get you. In English, Bruno. ¿Qué es lo que te está pasando? ¿Estás loco?
Okay, pasa. Tom, back loco. To you.
Yo no estoy loco y soy muy normal. Tú eres una chica loca como mí.
Oh my, talk about embarrassing. If you thought it couldn't get any worse than that, you were wrong. This is the type of video that, quite honestly, I've been avoiding for the longest time. Because I remember being so uncomfortable watching Charo on Dancing with the Stars, not because of her dancing, mostly because she is one of the most disruptive and most embarrassing contestants I have ever seen. So I thought to myself, you know, some people will request me to do a video on Charo, I'm just gonna do it for the heck of it. With the Dance with the Stars partnership predicted that they would make it farther than the first or second elimination, but sometimes it doesn't always live up to expectations. So let's get into it. Maria Rosario Pilar Martinez Molina Beaza, who professionally known simply by her stage name Charo, is a Spanish-American actress, singer, comedian, as well as a guitarist. But in America, she is known as the Chuchi Chuchi Girl because Chuchi Chuchi has taken her all the way to the bank. She would also make a number of television appearances as well. There's too many of appearances that she's been a part of. I just decided not to tell you guys all of it because that would make it longer. As well as some movie appearances. When she did Dancing with the Stars season 24, she would be partnered with Keo Mosby. Of course, Keo does have his share of bad partners that wouldn't last long, whether it's being out the first or second elimination, depending on the partner he has. At first, I kind of figured that Charo was an okay fit for Keo, because since Charo has a lot of performance experience, my prediction was for them to make it past the first or second elimination. At first, Keo was really excited to be partnered with Charo because she is a legend. But sadly, it didn't live up to any expectations. When they first got onto the dance floor, they would start off okay, but the potential that I saw from Charo was good, but Charo kept embarrassing everyone, especially Kyo. But the next dance, Charo was doing her own thing at times, and not doing the steps that Kyo taught her, and the things were just getting worse and worse for Kyo like you saw earlier. But in week 3 was much calmer like we all wanted, and she would also have some arguments with Bruno like you saw earlier.
Más crazy de Cristri, como en Blade de Mara, chiqui boom, chiqui boom, chiqui boom. Si soy el Cuban P, el más crazy de Cristri, cuando rico este ritmo me voy, chiqui boom, chiqui boom. Ven señorita a bailar y a guarachar con el rumbero, baila mi son, que sabroso. Que cuando bailas tu swing, me hace sentir muy santunguero con tu canción. Crazy de Cali Street, como en Blade de Mara, chiqui boom, chiqui boom, chiqui boom. Si soy el Cuban P, el más crazy de Cali Street, bueno rico este ritmo me voy, chiqui boom, chiqui boom.
Yeah! Hey! Charo! And Kyo!
You know, the last thing Charo said to Bruno was, "Bruno, I'll see you at the parking lot." Anyway, so Charo's Dance with the Stars stats are this: 3 dances, 70 points, and an average score of 23.3, and would finish 11th. Imagine that if those moments never happened, Kyo would have had a much more respectable run that season. But I give Kyo so much credit for handling it like a trooper. There was also a moment in week 2 where she threatened to quit the show. It was quoted saying that if you thought Charo was passionate on the Dancing with the Stars ballroom floor, you haven't seen anything yet. News have learned that the Fiery Flamingo guitarist is threatening to give up her Mirrorball Trophy dreams and walk away from the competition altogether. Charo was super upset this week about her scoring, and she feels like she's being treated and scored unfairly. She was telling producers that she doesn't like how they're underscoring her, and she feels like she's being treated so badly, and she was threatening to quit. Just to let you guys know, That didn't happen. It got so bad that Tom had to bring in the security guard by his side just in case anything worse happens, keeping Charo from hurting him or anybody else. Charo is a fantastic performer overall, but because of her moments on the show, she's without a doubt a Dancing with the Stars bust, as they would go on to have one of the most disruptive and most embarrassing partnerships in Dancing with the Stars history. And that'll do it for this video, so hit that subscribe button and leave a like on this video and leave a comment down below. And also turn on the post notification bell to keep up to date on my next Dancing with the Stars content video. And once again, that'll do it for another video. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is Eric Sharkey, aka Dancing with the Stars Superfan. Catch you next time.